Hi folks, it's been a while, I know, but I am going to be doing today a basic instructional guide on how to put our HO lighting kits into one of our HO Superliners. This has been requested for a real long time, so figured good time as any to get right into it. So we'll get to you later. I'm going to start off with just the basic assembly of the lighting kit. Now what you see here, minus these, what you see here is the basic contents of your lighting kit. So now we'll go over how to put all of this together. This is the core of your lighting kit here. You've got your bracket. Now you may note, if you take a little look here, there are two pins, one, two, on here and on your PCB. Well, there's lots of holes, but specifically, these large holes right here, one, two. Up here, there's only one, so cannot fit on this side. Doesn't work. See, doesn't fit. So there's only one way to put this together, which is conveniently the right way. So just slip that in there. You see, those two pins are gone through those two holes, and that is lying flat. So, step one, done. Step two is going to involve these little guys here. So, looking at your light board here, you'll see you've got these two kind of fins that stick out on either side. Now, we've got one that's bare and one that's got metal on it. So, you're going to take these, and you're going to slide them. Sorry, it's a little small here. You're going to slide them with that little metal hook on the underside onto the board, onto that metal post. Like that. So that on the other side, it's mounted like that. I do the same one, same with the other side. I take this piece. I'm going to slide it onto that metal post. Just like that. All right. Now I've got this flipped over. I'm going to take these pieces. You'll see that they also have a little kind of a little notches here for grabbing onto one of these posts. So you're going to orient it so that you want this flap to be sitting on top of that right there. So I'm going to just slide this one on, give a little push, and you should see how that one is just sitting kind of pressed against the other flap. That's just how you want it. So I'm going to do the same for the other side. I'm going to take this one. I'm going to just slide it on. There you go. That's your basic assembly for this PCB unit done. So now you're ready to mount it in your car. But first, I'm going to have to take the car apart. So what I have here is one of our HO Superliners. Specifically, this is the Superliner 2 transition sleeper. This process, though, can be used on any of our superliners or indeed any of our bi-levels as well. There'll be a little differences here and there in terms of the internal construction, but the basic process is going to be the same. So I'm going to start off with taking it apart. So I'm just going to kind of grab onto here for a base. I'll use my thumb and just peel that back a little bit and pull. It should kind of just pop loose. Simple enough. And this will just lift away. And I'll just set that there for now. So here we have the inside here. You're going to want to be a little careful. If you see these red tubes, these are specific to the superliners. The bi-levels won't have these, but for here you're just going to want to lift to separate these. Just pop that up and pull it out that way. And set them down. Same thing, just pop it up and pull out. These are slotted into the body. They form these little lights here, so you want to be careful that you don't just pull them up. And you'd want to be careful you don't try and pull this out without removing these. So, we come to this part. This might be a little tricky, and this may take a little BFI, brute force and ignorance, but what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to loosen this. So, I've got this side loose. And I'll show you kind of how it's locked in, and you'll see kind of why it takes so much to get this loose here. Because it doesn't want to let go, so I'm going to kind of just... It helps if you've got some tweezers or something you can kind of wedge under there and pry up. There we go. So, and what was holding that in, you see these little pegs here. There's two on this side. There's only one on this side, which is why this came up so much easier. They actually peg into these little holes here in the roof. So we'll set this aside. We'll set this aside, and we are ready to go. So we will start with where we began, which is our underframe. Now, the lighting kits come with some metal pieces that look like this, but are actually quite short. You cannot use those because, obviously, Superliners, Bi-Levels, and the like, they are very tall cars, so they need special electrical pickups just for them. So, inside the box for your Superliner or your Bi-Level, you will find a pair of these. It will be in the little plastic baggie underneath the foam in your box. So, you'll take two of those out. What you're going to want to do is slide them in right in there. You'll see this notch that's on both sides. It's about in the middle of the car, and you'll kind of see there's a little, like a little circuit board or something inside there. So you just want to take this, just slide it in, just like that. Take that one, slide it in, just like that. This is ready. Set it aside. We're going to return to our friend here, our little lighting circuit. So, in addition to the PCB in your lighting kit, you will have two of these. So, there is only one way that these are going to lock into this and into this. So, once you've got everything done, everything should be held in place. If nothing's held in place, you've probably got something backwards. So, just don't panic, take it all apart. Take a look at it, try again. So, what I'm going to do is, simplest way to kind of orient this is to actually attach these to this first. So, if you take a look at these, you'll notice that it's there's actually a little kind of groove running along one side of the light bar. And that groove conveniently will latch into these little... Focus. Will latch into these little grippy bits on the frame. So, you see here, little nubs. You're going to want to orient this so that this wide white piece is far away from here. You're going to orient it so that this groove is kind of grabbing onto these little nubs. So I'm just going to take this, just kind of pop it in. And if you've done it right, you should be able to let go and it'll just be held in there. So, I'm going to do the same one with the other one. I'm just going to take this white stripe or white triangle far away, groove part facing down. I'm just going to kind of slot it in. I have this upside down. Try again. Slot it in. Held in place. All right. Next step is going to be putting this into here. So, this is a little tricky. This is probably the part where you're gonna swear the most, as it were, but it's just a matter of kind of knowing where everything has to go and understanding how this is all supposed to be set up. So, a few things. These little slots here are going to grab these little shoes, as they're called, on the end here. They're going to kind of keep the lighting kit in place and allow the these metal parts to kind of slide into there when we're reassembling everything. We also have a series of little grabby tabs on the inside here. They're going to hold on to these light bars. So, and then the last thing you're going to see is these little notches, or these little nubs, and the notch piece, that groove that's in the side of these light bars, are going to rest along those. So all of this is going to kind of work together to hold this in place, and once you're done, it'll actually be very secure. So for starters, I'm going to take a look here. You see how you've got the shoe here and then this notch right here. These little four dots kind of are indicating the center of the car, and this little grabby part is off center, which is appropriate because these shoes are not centered on this light kit. So that should give you an idea of how this is supposed to go in there. If you do it backwards, it will fit, at least at first, but you will run into problems once you start trying to reassemble the car. Stuff just won't fit in place. You'll be tearing your hair out. So let's avoid that and let's put it in properly. So I will try and show you this as best I can. I've got my light bar here in assembly, and I'm just going to try and slide that in to place. And I'll slot that down, showing that there. It's all a little bit loosey-goosey until it gets locked in. I'm going to try. And this is much easier also if you're not trying to film yourself. So I try and get these light bars notched, locked by those notches. See how I kind of locked that in there? Now that's stable, so I can kind of get the other one done. Orient this, get that locked in there, and then press down there. And now both sides are locked in. So what I did was I basically got it kind of in the rough position, snapped down one side, got this into place, and snap down the other side. And now, locked in place. No problems. Just like that. So, now that you've done that, time for reassembly. This is the part where if you have not quite put that in the right place, this is where everything will go wrong. But since we've done it right, and hopefully you will do it right as well, everything should go fine. So, to start with, basic information. You'll see here, a little arrow here. You'll see molded on here, there's another arrow. Whenever you're dealing with any Kato products, whether locomotives or passenger cars, freight cars, whatever, the assembly process, you're always going to run into these little arrows. And making your life, something to make your life much easier is just to remember, always make sure those arrows point the same direction. So, arrow pointing that way, arrow pointing that way. That means we've got this lined up properly, so I'm just going to slot this in, press it down. I should lock into place those two little tabs I showed you earlier. Yeah, that's held. That's held. Just like that. Next up, you're going to want to put these in place. So, you've got your two little notches, new nubs here. You got these two end bits, which you're going to want to slide through the holes in there and poke out the other side. So, again, this is trickier to do in front of a camera than it is in reality. So, I'm just going to put that in place and kind of make sure those are poking through. I'm going to do the same for the other side. Try not to block the camera. Slot those into place. And press them in. Just like that. They're poked through. All good. Now, last part. We've got our underbody with our little metal fins here. Those metal fins are going to slide up through these gaps here. So, again, you're just going to keep an eye out for arrows. Arrows on this side this time, so I'm going to turn that around. So, can see how once I've got this assembled, those are going to go right in those slots. So I'm just going to close that up. And what happens since everything's lined up, those metal fins are going to go up through there, and they're actually going to press into those metal shoes on that light bar up in there and make a positive contact. So as a result, this car should now have interior lighting. So let's take it to the test track and see if it worked. Alright, and there you have it. That was the installation process for putting a Kato lighting kit into one of our Superliners. You can use the same basic process for putting one of these lighting kits into our Pullman Bi-Levels as well. Again, same basic principle. You do get a few extra pieces in these packages, like these reflective sticky strips, which you can use if you want. They'll just stick up into the roof. They're not really that necessary though. There's also a little that little orange piece in there, which is a color filter, which will, if you want to kind of dim down that sort of harsh bluish whitish fluorescent light, make it a little warmer, give it a softer tone, that will just clip onto the PCB. It's fairly self-explanatory. There's little peg holes, it just sticks right on. So yeah, I hope that was informative, and thank you for watching.